أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، إن الله تعالى يقول في كتابه العزيز: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. ويقول سبحانه وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters, topic of our khutbah today is about sabr. Sabr, which is translated as patience, endurance, perseverance. Sabr has been mentioned in Quran al-Kareem in many ayat, in so many verses. And it is, in all of them, it is sometimes mentioned as a source of strength, as a source of support. A Muslim helps, it helps him to deal with the difficulties of life. But also at the same time, it is one of the attributes, one of the best, one of the most important attributes that a believer can have. وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اصْبِرُوا وَصَابِرُوا. Or you believe, endure and have patience. ويقول سبحانه وتعالى that He will surely test us. Part of Allah's sunnah, من سنة الله سبحانه وتعالى في عباده المؤمنين أنه يبتليهم. أنه يبتليهم. ومن الأمور التي يستعين بها المؤمن في مواجهة البلاء هو الصبر. فالله سبحانه وتعالى يؤكد في هذه الآية ويقول: ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين. الله سبحانه وتعالى reaffirms that you will certainly be tested with some sort of hardship from fear من الخوف بشيء. Some of fear, and fear is not something that one looks forward to. It is something that you come across. It comes to you, despite yourself. And it is not a pleasant thing. And it's a kind of worry, a kind of feeling of some sort of desperation. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ. You fear for yourself. You fear for your children. You fear for your property. You fear for your community and your country. Fear from an outside enemy. Fear from a poverty. Fear from an illness. Fear that you may lose your children. والجوع. بشيء من الخوف والجوع. الجوع is hunger, starvation, where sometimes there are people who may not be able to find enough food to feed their children. Sometimes to the extreme that people are desperate to find some food to feed themselves. بشيءٍ من الخوف والجوع. And you know, hunger, we live by eating. Part of Allah's Sunnah, the way He created us, we have to eat to sustain our body, to maintain our level of energy. If we do not eat, we become weak. And when we are weak, we are unable to help ourselves. And we are unable to perform ibadat. And that is why in eating, when you eat in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you thank Him. When you thank Him and remember Him, you are being rewarded. الأكل يأكله المرء وهو يبتغي به وجه الله سبحانه وتعالى ليتقوى على الطاعة وعلى عبادة الله فهي تكتب له عبادة. So when he is deprived of food, it is a test. How do you react to that? بشيء من الجوع والخوف ونقص من الأموال, a loss of wealth, your business, your investments, they did not bring you what you were expecting. You made major losses suddenly overnight, and we have seen it in this financial crisis that the world has seen in recent months. How some people they've lost overnight most of what they thought they owned in shares. Shares that become without a value, that become worthless. They thought they had millions. Overnight they found themselves they are just like anybody else, like the majority of us. Now, a Muslim who's being tested in his growth, in his business, how would he deal with that kind of situation? Should he do like some people, they go and commit suicide, throw themselves from the fifth floor of their apartment? Some of them, they say, well, now I can offer and provide my children the comfort as they used to do. I cannot be up to their expectations, so he goes and finishes his life. Is that the way of a believer? Of course not. How do you deal with such a case? With patience, with sabr, with endurance, with referring things to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is He who gave us the money and the wealth in the first place. If He chooses to take it, that is His decision subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا يسأل عما يفعل وهم يسألون. هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. It is He who provides. He is the provider, the sustainer, سبحانه وتعالى. ونقص من الأموال. And sometimes that is not even what one might have suffered from losses. It could reach the anfus. You could lose somebody dear to you. A plague, a disease, an earthquake, a natural disaster, an outside enemy, who mistakenly or intentionally bombs your house, and overnight you find that half of your family have gone. And we have seen that. We have seen that in the news, in many places of the world, and especially among Muslims. May Allah replace them in their losses. May Allah give them the patience and the strength to cope with the big losses that they have incurred. And it wasn't only a few months ago that we've seen it on television. How Muslim families in Gaza, they were bombed indiscriminately. And you'll find after the war people are counting their losses. There was this young man, Allah has to remember his face. And he was counting the people he lost. He said, I lost my mother, my father, my uncle, my auntie, my little brother, my wife, my little boy. And he continues about 20 people in one go. And he was talking as if, he said, I am not sure whether I am alive or dead. What happened is a dream. Is it a nightmare that I will wake up out of it, or is it real? We say, it's a story. But imagine yourself, you are the one who's counting his losses. You've lost your wife, you've lost your dear children, you've lost your mother, your father, your uncle, your aunties. How would you cope with that? If it was not for the patience, إِلَّنْ يَسْتَعِنِ الْمُؤْمِنُ بِالصَّبْرِ وَالْإِحْتِسَابِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلُ فَمَنْ يُعَوِّذُهُ فِي أَهْلِهِ فَمَنْ يُعَوِّذُ عَلَيْهِ مُصَابًا. Who would replace him in his losses? Can anyone in the world bring him again his family? No one. But he can find comfort, he can find ease. Not, I don't think he would reach the state of comfort, but he may cope with it. He may can handle the size of the musibah, the extent of the disaster that has befallen his family, with the patience, with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. باستعانته بالله واستحضار الله سبحانه وتعالى الذين إن أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. هذا كلام المؤمن. والصبر إخواني أخواتي إنما الصبر عند الصدمة الأولى. Patience is the first reaction is when you hear the news of bad loss. Bad news about your business, about your family members, is how do you react to that loss. When you remember Allah at that moment, and you bring His presence in your life, and you console yourself with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He is watching over you, and nothing that has befallen you would have missed you in years other Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَهُوَ سَيُسَاعِدُكَ عَلَى تَجَاوُزِ الْمِحْنَةِ والتعامل مع المصيبة سبحانه وتعالى بالصبر والاحتسان والثمرات. ونقص بشيء من الخوف ونقص in those matters we mentioned as in ثمرات. ثمرات are those people who live from the land. Those who invest all their capital in their land. And they will harvest what they have invested from effort at the end of the year or at the end of the season. And when he sells the crops and the products, he gets back his money and his profit again with it. And sometimes that does not work. Because a farmer who grows wheat, who grows corn, he does not control the rain. He has no power over the weather. He has no power whether his crops will grow the way he wants it, the way he dreamt about it. It's only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who can make it what he wants it to be. Subhanallah. كثيراً لكن في نفس الوقت at the same time. If it was a bad season, if it was drought, no rain, sand instead of rain, high temperature instead of mild temperature, no wheat comes out, no corn comes out, no dates come out. Sometimes people, they have grown, they're looking for their palm trees and suddenly they are affected by a disease and they can see how their crop is being destroyed in front of their eyes, and they can't do nothing. They couldn't do anything about it. كيف يتعامل المرء مع هذه المصيبة? It is not much different to the one who invested in shares. He needs to have patience. الصبر, my dear brothers, الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول إن الله مع الصابرين. Allah is with those who have patience, who have endurance. Well, you may say, well, I'm not a farmer. I have no money, I have no shares, I have no problems. Believe me, my dear brothers, everyone will be tested to his level and to his means. Wallahi, he had not this summer that I am talking about. If you have not tasted it, you have not tasted something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted to those favored ones. وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ. You are blessed if you have patience. Now let us come to some hadith in this respect that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about sabr. في حديث عن أبي مالك الحارث بن عاصم الأشعري رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الطهور أو الطهور شطر الإيمان والحمد لله تملأ ميزان وسبحان الله والحمد لله تملأ وتملأان ما بين السماء والأرض ما بين السماوات والأرض والصلاة نور والصدقة برهان والصبر ضياء والقرآن حجة لك أو عليك كل الناس يبدو فبائع نفسه فمعتقها فموبقها حديث صحيح رواه مسلم. In this hadith, صلى الله عليه وسلم says that cleanliness or wudu is half of the iman. Without wudu, your prayer cannot be accepted. If you did not have your tahoor today, every Muslim could have had his wash. He had performed wudu before coming to prayer. At-tahoor, shatr al-iman. Wa alhamdulillah, tamla'u al-mizan. Alhamdulillah, my dear brothers, signifies thanking Allah. تعني الشكر. تعني الشكر لله سبحانه وتعالى على نعمه التي لا تحصى. My dear brother, my dear sister, we are blessed. We have yet another day in this life. We are in good health. We feel secure in our houses. We have our children with us. We have no worry about lunch. We have already planned it and sorted it out. You're going to order the lunch from the best restaurant. Or you're going to have the best cook who's cooking lunch for you. You're going to invite your friends to enjoy lunch with you. You may have invited them to a restaurant you wanted to have the pleasure of eating. You do not have the burden of loans. Nobody is after you asking for money back. You are in comfort. You are able to walk to your car. You are able to drive your car. You can see your way with your eyes. You can enjoy the sight around you. You can enjoy the sight of the sea, the greenery of the palm trees. You agree with me. We all have those. Thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is, my dear brothers and sisters? What do you do? What do you say to the one who gave you all that? Do you think you gave them to yourself? Do you think you make yourself strong? Do you think because you exercise? Do you think because you had a good breakfast that, mashallah, you are strong and you are able and walking? Don't fool yourself. Don't fool yourself and don't be among the mughaffaleen, al-ghafileen. اذكر الله يذكرك اشكر الله على نعم يزدك. Thank Allah for what He gave you and He will give you more. ولئن شكرتم لأزيدنكم. الحمد لله تملأ الميزان. الحمد لله is a word you should say often. الحمد لله for everything, for every ni'mah, for every step you walk, for every glimpse you have, say Alhamdulillah. For the touch of your child, say Alhamdulillah. To see your wife beside you, say Alhamdulillah. The food is laid on your table, say Alhamdulillah. لا تنسى أخي المسلم أختي المسلمة لا تنسى الحمد لله عز وجل. فحمد الله وشكره عون لنا على المصائب وهو سبحانه وتعالى الذي سيرزقنا الصبر والتحمل على المصائب. وسبحان الله سبحان الله in the wonders that He created, in the wonders that are around us. سبحان الله in everything and for everything. سبحان الله والحمد لله would fill between the heavens and the earth. Would you, do you want to have your scale heavy on the day of judgment? Wouldn't you like to be among the successful, those who got their book by their right hand? Say Alhamdulillah. No wonder, my dear brothers, your prayer will not be accepted if you do not read the Fatiha. If you do not say Alhamdulillah Ya Rabbi Al-Alamin. Was-salatu nur. Prayer is light. As-salat nur, my dear brothers. As-salat defines our way. A person without faith, he is in darkness. Wallahi, الذي لا يعرف ربه فهو في ظلماته. فوقها ظلمات لا يرى طريقه ولا يهتدي إلى سبيله ولا يعرف طريق النجاة في هذه الحياة. فالنور أخي المسلم، الصلاة أخي المسلم أختي المسلمة هي نورك في هذه الحياة، هي نور دربك، هي السراج الذي تستعين به في السير في هذه الحياة، في أقصر طريق إلى مرضات الله عز وجل، إلى جنة الخلد. Prayer is your life to the shortest path, to Allah's pleasure. To Allah's pleasure and to His Jannah. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He may grant everyone in this mosque place in Jannah insha'Allah. And place our parents and our relatives and all the Muslims Jannah insha'Allah. By His grace subhanahu wa ta'ala. Was-salatu nur. والصدقة برهان. And charity, my dear brother and sister, when you take away money that you have earned and you take some of it and you give it to another person, to a lady, out of faith, this is a proof of your iman. This is a proof of your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أن الشيطان لم يخيفك من الفقر وأنك تتصدق من مالك وأنت موقن بأن الذي أعطاك المال سيعطيك غيره وأكثر منه. قد تغلبت على شح نفسك والنفس أمارة بالسوء. And believe me, my dear brothers, giving money away, it is not easy for the ordinary person, but for the one who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gives it with assurance, with pleasure. And he does not need somebody to tell him to do it. At the end of his zakat year, he will bring out, even if it is a million dinar, he will give it, because that is not his money. That is the money of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If it means 1 kg zakat, he will give it away. If it is 1 million, he will give it away because he is a believer. Not only zakat, he gives voluntary sadaqah. And my dear brothers and sisters, believe me, the money you are saving, it is not the one that you have in the account. That may lose its value overnight, but it is those money, those things you have given for the sake of Allah, they are saved with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Al-Udhiyya, in Eid Al-Adha, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sacrificed the lamb, a big lamb. He gave 3/4 of it. He was said, give that to that and that. Aisha told him, Ya Rasulullah, مَا أَبْقَيْتَ لَنَا? What have you left for us? He said, Aisha, I have saved everything for us except this one. Whatever you have given, you have saved it. But I am not saying that you should not plan your economy. Economize, plan for the future of your children. That is nothing wrong with it. But give sadaqah when you are still able to do so. Give sadaqah when you are still able to do so. Because the money, no matter how much you accumulate, one day you are going to leave them behind you to somebody who will inherit it without an effort and who may not necessarily spend it in the right way that you may have done in your lifetime. So my dear brother, my dear sister, save your share by sadaqah. Save your share from your wealth by giving it fi sabilillah. That is your share from your money, because everything else belongs to al-waratha, to those who will inherit you. It is your choice. وَالصَّبْرُ ضِيَاءُ الصَّبْرُ ضِيَاءُ. Notice, he says صَلَاتُ نُورُ and الصَّبْرُ is ضِيَاءُ. ضِيَاءُ, linguistically, in English language, they translate it as light. But in Arabic, al-nur is that bright and cold nur of, for example, the moon. And the ziya is the light that we get from the sunshine. It is bright and warm. Sabr brings warmth, brings light into your life and strength. Brothers, we have some brothers standing outside. Can you please come forward, make space for them to come in? Please, just move a little bit. There are people standing in the sunshine, in the heat of the sun. Please move just a little step in front. Fi sabilillah. Do it for the sake of Allah. Please. Fi sabilillah. Sadaqah. You have made room for your brother. You have picked yourself from your comfortable sitting for the sake of Allah. And you will be rewarded for it. Fi hadithin. صلى الله عليه وسلم عن أبي سعيد بن مالك ابن سنان الخدري رضي الله عنهما أن الناس من الأنصار سألوا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فأعطاه ثم سألوه فأعطاه حتى نفذ ما عنده فقال لهم حين أنفق كل شيء بيده ما يكون من خير فلم أدخره عليه ومن يستعفف يعفه الله ومن يستغني يغنيه الله ومن يتصبر يصبره الله وما أعطي أحد عطاء خيرا وأوسع من الصبر. حديث, it's a great hadith, beautiful hadith. It is reported that a group of Al-Ansar, they were asking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to give him or to give them some of what he had. And he gave them, then they asked again, he gave them again till he had nothing left with him. Then he told them some words of advice. He said, Wallah, if I had more, I would have spent it on you. I would not save anything, not to spend it on you. But من يستعفف, whoever seeks to fill, whoever seeks to be satisfied, Allah will make him satisfied. من يستعفف يعفه الله. ومن يستغني, and whoever forsakes asking people, Allah will be sufficient for him. And whoever trains himself to be patient, Allah will give him patience. وَمَنْ يَتَصَبَّرْ يُصَبِّرُ اللَّهِ. If you try to be patient, Allah will make you patient, will help you to be patient. وَمَا أُعْطِيَ أَحَدٌ عَطَاءً خَيْرًا مِنَ الصَّبْرِ. And no one, nothing would have been given to you better than sabr. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us sabr, to have sabr, to have the pleasure of Allah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين. أحمد وحمد الشاكرين وأصلي وأسلم على نبيه الأمين المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. My dear brothers, يعني the topic of sabr is so big, but and there are so many hadith, so many ayat, but I think it is sufficient for what we have today. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who listen to good words and live by them. Allahumma, and let us pray on Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. عباد الله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وقيل واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا الا غفرته ولا دينا الا قضيته ولا هما الا فرجته ولا مريضا الا شفيته. اللهم انصر الاسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر الاسلام والمسلمين. اللهم ارزقنا الصبر يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا من عبادك الصابرين. اللهم لا تبتلينا وان ابتليتنا فارزقنا الصبر يا رب العالمين. عباد الله,